Cherry blossoms quickly spring to mind when talking about flowers in Japan. A variety called Prunus yedoensis has been introduced throughout the country on account of its beautiful short-lived blossoms that flower in unison before the tree develops any leaves. The 600 or so varieties of cherry blossoms we see today are derived from just 7 native species, including Prunus pendula and Cerasus speciosa. Prunus pendula is a particularly long-lived variety, with some trees living in excess of 1,000 years. Cerasus speciosa is resistant to sea breezes, allowing it to grow near the coast. The sweetly scented leaves are also used to decorate Japanese cuisine. Prunus yedoensis was artificially created through the cross-fertilization of Prunus pendula and Cerasus speciosa during the Edo period. Displaying characteristics of both varieties, Prunus yedoensis is superbly adapted to both mountainous and coastal environments, grows rapidly, and lives for a long time. It cannot, however, seed, as it is an F1 hybrid variety that relies on human transplantation. The existence of aged trees and their extensive dispersion throughout Japan has led to misconceptions about it being a native species. All Prunus yedoensis are genetically identical clones that have been artificially transplanted. Being genetically identical and widespread makes Prunus yedoensis an excellent sensor for measuring natural phenomena, such as the familiar cherry blossom front that announces the arrival of spring as it works its way up the Japanese archipelago. The flowering sensor of Prunus yedoensis is quite well understood. Sensors are contained inside flower buds for the following year that have already developed when blossoms have fallen to the ground and leaves begin to grow. However, the sensor doesn't activate until the leaves fall in autumn. The sensor switch remains dormant until activated by the falling leaves. After all the leaves have fallen in winter and the temperature drops for a certain period of time, the second switch is activated and the flowers prepare to blossom. Once this second switch is activated, growth gradually begins to accelerate in sync with the average daily temperature, indicating the existence of not only temperature, but also optical sensors capable of measuring the length of each day. Although the severity and duration of winter and the onset of spring may vary, cherry trees blossom at the same time almost every year. Evidence points to the existence of a yet-to-be-discovered third sensor, in addition to those measuring temperature and sunshine, that must compensate for these seasonal variations. The readily recognizable and extensively studied Prunus yedoensis is yet to give up the secrets behind its mysterious flowering mechanism. Humans do not have such refined sensors with which to measure the natural world. However, humankind possesses the power of analysis, one that goes beyond our natural limitations. The protection of this diverse and beautiful Earth through the analysis of nature is a mission that has been entrusted to humankind.